Hello everybody, welcome back to XCOM 2 with me, Flick. I'm going back to the world map to see that we have a supply drop that we didn't fully get, but that's fine. Increases reaching income? No, not now. We're finishing making contacts so we can do the story mission.
Setting course for Eastern
Although
United
we need to make sure
States.
At least 7 days pass or I can't bring Lenoria on the final mission. But that wouldn't be that terrible. She's great at taking out sector pods, but so is CR. So if I had to leave her, that'd be okay. Oh, that's now a 3-pip facility as well. If I was really desperate, I could go do that.
Commander, if we want to set back the aliens' work on the Avatar project, we should hit one of
No, we're not interested in setting it back, Bradford. Possible. We're interested in stopping it now. That's what we're hoping to do today. We got a Shred Storm Cannon, a more aggressive variant of the Shredder Gun. The Shred Storm Cannon fires razor-sharp particles in a cone to devastate close proximity targets. All right. And you have Fortress, so you're now immune to most status effects, and we'll give you Domination. Still wounded. Yep, still wounded. Alright. So that's us now got access to the story mission. I don't think I have enough intel to buy all the options. We'll get the ones that are most important, like having an extra person come with us.
Signal's coming through clear.
Nice. So we can now do the mission. We're going to get another warsuit in 4 days. I don't really need that. I'll do a save.
Come at.
Oh, what are you saying?
But we've still got room to grow here. We should consider building some new facilities.
We don't need new facilities, Shen. Thanks. Thanks, but no thanks. We'll make a new save. Why not? There we are. Save 22. Alright, let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. I know Lenori's not back. That's fine. That actually makes my choices of who to bring better. Wait, was there? No, no. I thought there was an option to bring an extra person. Oh, wait, no, it was. Okay, so that's the. I can't see how much that costs because it's too long. There we are. 34. Squad gaining squad sight is pretty nice. Crit chance. We're definitely getting the crit chance. Vision. A vision is irrelevant if they have squad sight. We'll take that, and we'll take that. I don't have enough for that, even if I wanted it.
Commander, once we move on
Ooh,
the
it is
Advent
the
Network Tower, it's all or nothing. We won't have time to advance our research or deal with the wounded. We should only deploy once we're fully prepared. If we're going to infiltrate the Advent Network Tower, we'll have to use a smaller squad. Try to draw less attention to ourselves than we already do.
Oh, that's real bad. Do I get to make... I assume other people will join then. Do I want a healer for this? That's a difficult decision. I didn't realise we were doing this kind of thing. Those three together can get a lot of stuff killed. See, the problem is I don't know what's going to happen. I hope that you get the choice to bring more people, because I want my healer, but I don't want to use up a healer slot for a kill slot. That's weird. That's very weird.
Sky Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe, 5x5.
Maybe this
Commander,
isn't like the true final mission.
Put Advent down for the count. This will be a two-pronged assault. First, we hack the heart of the Advent Tower and disrupt their network before the speaker finishes his latest broadcast. Shen's cooking up a little surprise.
Yeah, okay, Bradford, I get it.
More than get their attention. With Advent in an uproar, we'll access the portal and take the fight to their front door. All goes well, they won't even see us coming. It's risky, but it's the best shot we'll get. Once we start this, there's no turning back. Move to infiltrate the network tower. Locate the access point and hack in to seize the broadcast signal.
Yeah? So it looks like we're on a set path here because you can't jump across. Squad integrated comm, squad precision. They better not fill this mission with sector pods, although I do have a sector pod killer, but still. Yeah, I'm pressing. I'm pressing for movement.
Moving on target location.
I'm glad I saved before actually making the decision of who to bring, because depending on the enemy composition, I could have brought like the entirely wrong squad. Maybe I should bring the healer, maybe I shouldn't, I don't know. Right, we double move to know that it's safe up there, so that means we can double move CR as well.
On the move.
And Taya's my pistol sniper. It's been a while since I've used her, but I remember that she can do some nasty things to the enemies that they won't soon forget. Well, I think I heard a mech. Yep, I hear a mech. That was not a sect pod stomping though, so there could be enemies in here, rather annoyingly. I guess I have to check.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
It's either that or get stabbed in the back. No enemies. Alright, not gonna use his other action just yet.
Roger that.
I like that I bought the ability where everybody is personally concealed, so even if someone does get seen, I'll still get the concealment bonuses for my other two.
Getting it done.
Assuming they aren't also in the line of sight, I suppose.
Rolling.
We've got something over here.
Okay. Don't have a turn limit. Oh. That better not be a sex bot smashing through scenery that I hear. So hang on. I can go down here, but that looks like an elevator. Where's my objective? There's my objective. So I can either go around this way, or go this way. Alright. I'm going to make a hard save here, different to the one I made just before selecting who I'm bringing on the mission.
Roger that.
Ooh, holy balls. So, Andromedan Muton, Andromedan... There's something else. Jesus Christ, you've got to kill that many with just three people. That'll be difficult. I'm pressing. Game, I'm pressing.
Confirmed.
I wanted to know what the other... I think it was an Archon, but I might be wrong. That's a lot of HP I'm going to have to do in one bloody turn. That will not get you seen, yeah.
10-4.
Give you bonus for being up higher. I'm going to initiate against this squad, actually. Putting everybody higher might be a good idea.
Overwatch. On Overwatch.
That's the Andromedan stomping off. Oh, stomping this way. Ooh, please don't see him. You had someone with you, I saw them. Where are they? Oh, explosive barrel? Ah, okay. Clearly I have to initiate on this squad this turn because they're blocking my way, but who do I initiate with? CR's got blue screen rounds. That doesn't matter because Andromedans don't count as robots. Who have you got line of sight of? Their only squad sight. Well, if I was to open with Void Rift, I would catch the explosive and most of them. Right, actually, I'll just overwrite the save I just did. I'm going to be save scamming like nobody's business here because it didn't prepare me for a three-person mission. And that is how we're opening. We're not going to open with overwatches because I want to have full control over people's turns. Oh, this is going to be bloody terrifying. The Andromedans are going to get to do stuff. That's the killer part.
The rift opens.
Even if I get them down to their shell. On the plus side, the other two will stay concealed, so they'll still get bonuses to hit. Oh, I did something to someone. Panic on the Muton if I had to guess. Oh, wait. Additional effects can miss?
Oh, come on.
Then why bother doing the animation? Why not just knock it? Oh, it was a codex. There we are. I don't have any flashbangs. Jolly good. Mid fire. Okay. If only we were a little bit bigger. The Andromedans are the deadliest thing here right now, so blaster bomb them both. No, CR, not the floor!
They're onto me.
They are onto you, yes. So now we get all our free turns. So I guess I should use face off first because you get three shots before. Ah, you can only see the codex though. In that case, I would rather use fanfire, and I hope that fanfire procs before the codex gets a chance to duplicate. Please.
I'm your huckleberry.
I'm your huckleberry? Yes! Didn't get a chance to replicate. Still not out of the woods by any stretch of the imagination.
They've seen me.
They have, yes. But now you get your free shot. Take your free shot. Got him down to his shell at least.
I got it, right? We might need this.
We might need what? We might need... Oh, he dropped loot. Face-off would only get one target. So just fire your pistol normally. Oh, you didn't do enough. I mean, I didn't expect you to, but still. Yep, there's proof that blue screen rounds affects pistols. So he's going to run up and punch, he'll probably throw a grenade. I mean, what can you do? I couldn't have done it. What? Jesus Christ! I mean, they only get to scatter this turn, right? But still! That's too many enemies for three troops. Is there a combination of people I could have brought to have handled that encounter better?
Medic!
I don't think so. Would Lenore have made a difference? No, because they're not mechanical. They're counting as biological. A mimic beacon would only survive two hits. So no, that wouldn't make a difference. That might save her from fatal damage. She'll take damage from the fall. Yeah, she took one from the fall, I think. Oh, because she got shot at, she gets to shoot back. And missed.
Missed!
Sophie's immune to acid, so... Oh, yeah, they double move. That's good. Jesus Christ. Well, you'll be doing face-off, I guess. Although if you fire your pistol as your first action, then you get to do another action. So absolutely take out this Andromedan. And then face-off. And see what happens. Oh, wow, nice. The armor absorbed most of that. It's a shame you just couldn't have taken him out.
Check it before you get too close.
Okay, so. If you do stasis, you can still do another action, correct? Yes. Stasis, the Andromedan that has crap tons of HP, so that's this one.
Shields!
And then I'm thinking, mind control this Andromedan to get on my side so I have another unit, because it should be 100% chance. Ah, it's not 100% chance at all. It is on that, but he's got one bloody HP. Ah! Save Scummit. Save Scummit, because this mission is very, very unfair so far.
Let me in.
If it fails, I'm just going to load and do something else. I'm not going to keep on trying to load and see if it works. Alright, it did work. Good. So I have four units now. It's still going to be troublesome killing an Andromedan in one turn, though. So CR's only goal this turn is to ensure that he's only going to get knocked down into bloody... I wonder if that will apply for him changing into the shell. That's not a good enough chance to hit. We can guarantee it. It's such a waste though. I kind of want CR to be the one to get punched. Oh, I'd get acid if I went there. I could run and gun to that point right there.
Pulling off!
See if that improves my chance to hit the guy. Knife 4. Good enough. So at least he can only punch now, and I don't think he can reach Taya and punch her. So that means he's going to punch CR or Sulfid. And it doesn't shred armor, at least. And we have another full health Andromedan to deal with as well as this one, though. He's pointing at CR, so I'm guessing he's punching CR. Yep. And he missed. That's very lucky.
Is that all you got? Watch the flanks!
Watch the flanks, I've not got cover anymore. So I don't have stasis. This thing needs to die, and we have to worry about the fact we have a full health Andromedan to deal with. I would get poisoned if I went that way, right? I'm not in cover right now, so I just... Well, that's not getting his cover. I worry about setting off something... Save Scum, the video game. I don't want to set off another pod, because I will die. And then we guarantee the kill by doing 100% chain shot. Yep. Can two units plus Archon kill a full health Andromedan? Probably not, but if I get it down to its shell form, it'll probably just go for the Archon because the Archon will be next to it.
You know that was good.
I do know that was good. That was very helpful, thank you. So, fire your pistol. You're not going to be able to see the... Oh no, you can see it. It's just your chance to hit it isn't very good. Well, if I use Sulfid first, I could Null Lance and that destroys cover, right? It says it's going to hit him.
My lance pierces all.
I hope it takes out his cover as well, because that's what I need to have happen. It did not. But it did do 10 damage and ignored his armor. The pistol shot from Taya is not going to ignore the armor. That's the only thing. What's your chance to hit this guy? 47? Move right next to his face, or as close as you can get. That's with Battle Frenzy as well. Thank you. Now he's probably going to be punched, but that's okay. Reactivate. I think reactivation should only be a percentage chance, like maybe a high chance, maybe like an 80% chance that he will... Oh, that's better. 50% chance to get the kill, if it's a crit. Did I just shoot the Archon by mistake because of the... No. Ooh, I would have been annoyed. It left him on 1 HP. So he's going to get the punch. Punch the Archon. Yeah, point at him and punch the Archon. Don't kill him though, because I would very much like an extra target. Yeah, that doesn't matter. He missed! I don't know what was up with that box, but he missed. It sounded like he said, oh shit, there. Alright, fire's going to spread to CR next turn, that's fine. Alright, we had a very successful turn. The Archon's going to kill this guy, probably. Now we move on, and there's probably at least... Well, wait, no, we know for a fact there's one more pod, don't we? Because we see an Archon right next to the objective. Or we did. He's moved now. So there's still at least three more enemies on this map. No. I want to... Give me my Archon. But he needs to... Oh yeah, look, the Archon staff's got ammunition. 85% chance, or... Yeah, I'll take the 85% chance to get the kill, thanks. Good. Thank God they didn't give you a time limit as well.
Moving to position.
You have full ammunition. Watch. You need to reload, but it's free. I don't want to move him up too much.
Back in.
Why can't I move you at all? What? What? CR stuck? The fire made it, like, inaccessible? What? Can't move CR. Alright, I guess I just have to hope... Well, maybe I use up my last plasma grenade to destroy the scenery to get him out. I can't believe I have to do that. That's garbage, but he's stuck. It didn't even destroy the cover! The cover is immune, apparently. Alright, we're down to... Well, we're technically back to having three people.
Already there.
If I have to also extract, though, that CR is dead because I can't move him through scenery. And now if I wanted to save him, I would have to restart the mission because I've overwritten since he moved there. Well, I don't want to do the mission again. It's gone fairly well so far. I have another heavy, but that's garbage. If CR gets left behind, it's due to a glitch, and that sucks. As I say, it's too late. I mean, I have the autosave at the start of the mission, but I don't want to do the mission again because I feel like I've gotten very lucky with some of the shots.
I'm on it.
In situations, we're lucky that Taya is only almost dead, not actually dead.
That's one of their transmitters. They didn't put a whole lot of effort into disguising the alien tech involved.
The design may be a function of the network itself. The amount of psionic energy filtered through that system is beyond measure.
Okay. I'd love to move ECR, but you can't move, so Overwatch.
Got it covered.
Copy that.
The fire isn't spreading, the fire's out. God damn it. God damn XCOM.
On your order.
I was expecting him to see that Archon through there, but actually there's a wall in the way. I definitely want to wait one more turn. Why? Because then I get the rift back.
Got
that's
it.
Real good.
Moving.
So they're kind of perched up. CR can't do anything. So we have Archon CR. They've got a long movement range. What even is that? I'm going to try and move him in the middle of nowhere. After I save. In case it just outright kills him. There you go, CR. Move out there. Move. Move. Actually, you know what I could do if I have to call the Sky Ranger? Oh, well, if I do have to call it, I can have the squares overlap like there and there. That might save him.
Come get some. Got it covered.
New turn already? New turn already. We know there's at least an Archon in here, and... there's not usually squads of one. Hang on. Could come in through the roof. Yeah, it could come in through the roof. Next turn.
On the move.
Not going to open the door this turn because I want both of them up there ideally. I'm pressing for you to move to the square. Move to the square that I'm telling you to move to. I'm pressing the button. Move to the square. There we go.
That'll be okay.
If this is the final mission, they've done a piss poor job so far. Let's put it that way.
Overwatch.
Getting characters stuck in scenery.
Get some.
Can't press on squares I want to move to. You know, the usual. Giving you four people for no good reason, or sorry, three people for no good reason. You come in on a bloody loud Sky Ranger. Alright, so if I move Taya to the window, she should see.
I'm trusting you here.
Yeah. Three goddamn Archons. Jesus Christ. So. We'll do Lightning Hands because it's free. Must keep in mind I can't just fire the pistol once because I already moved. Good crit. Now, do I fire three times at one Archon to get the kill or do I try and wound all of them? That's a good question. Are they both getting hit by that? They are both getting hit by that. Well, hang on. Stasis first, because it doesn't end my turn. Oh, you can't see anybody from there. Okay, if I move you there, you still have one action left. But hang on, stasis uses up one action, though. Alright, Mr. Suicidal Archon, what are you doing? I don't know. I hit both them, he'll be very close to death. He might, with face-off, go down, and then my Archon can finish them off. CR, can you actually see? Can CR... CR can see because I bought the squad sight upgrade. It's the only shot he's got. It's the only shot he's getting, so he takes it, and we'll see what happens, and then I'll decide what I'm doing. Yep, but only for four, which is not good enough. Yeah, I can't move with Soul Food, Stasis, and Void Rift, and he can't see anybody's Stasis from there, so I don't actually really have a choice about what to do. As annoying as that is. So we'll Void Rift both of them.
Welcome to the Void.
My ideal here is mind controlling one of them for a couple of turns. Panic would be okay as well. I was trying something on one of them. And I missed it. Maybe him as well.
Shot wide.
Yeah, he's trying something on the other one. Mind control, perfect. Alright, well in that case... The Archon that I already have... He took more damage? Oh, because he got ruptured. He's still alive though, right? Yeah. So the Archon I have forever, he should probably just move there and... There's no way he's killing either of them, but I just have to create a nicer looking target than Taya. So he's not in cover, he's getting flanked. All that nonsense. 65% on that guy, take it. It's your best shot. Might as well. So now we have an interesting decision. How much damage would I do with one pistol shot? Oh wait, face off would try and hit my... Would hit... Which one? Ah, the one that isn't fully mind controlled. It would do not enough to kill him. New save. I don't like this mission at all. Fanfire then. Not on the one I've got controlled. On the one with the most HP would make the most sense. And it will kill him. Because there'll all be 100% chances. Like, she only needed one. That's annoying. I bet if I'd done face-off she wouldn't have credited it. Oh, fire spreading behind her there, but I didn't see. Go after one of the Archons, otherwise you're a dick. He won't go after that one because he knows the AI will know that's temporary, but I assume he'll go after this one. Oh, wait, you are going after that one? Oh, you fool! You foolish fool! He just bought me a turn. He's still got holo targeting debuff as well. We'll see if CR can see him just to use CR's turn for that. Also, was that Taya falling through the floor? No. No, CR doesn't have a sight on anything. Oh, we got that turn successfully done. Half-eaten corpse is right. So, Mr. Archon, can you just kill him? 50-50. Alright, we'll take your 50-50 chance, because I assume you can't hack. That was... You did Stormtroopers proud there. I think I need to move Taya.
Okay, I'll go.
One pistol shot from her might not actually do it. Although again, we don't have a time limit, so it doesn't really matter if I don't do it this turn. No, that's on the mind controlled one, you stupid game! We're not accepting that. Why on earth do you make the default something you have permanent control of for the whole mission? Don't be so stupid. Good grief.
What's over there?
Second target. God, it was saying for a second that I only had the one target. But you don't crit this one. No, you did, but not enough still. So, Soulfood needs to get the kill here. Oh wait, it's gone back to before I had this guy's turn. Well, I'll do as I did and it should still miss, but I don't think it'll. I thought you had to set a second wave option for results of rolls to be different on save scums.
Come get some.
Right, so for the next turn he can hack it.
Target in range. Move to hack the command console. Gaining access.
System override. Reduce contact cost, but it doesn't matter. We're not going to get either of these. We actually got closer than I thought we would.
We've got access. Status confirmed. We have control of the network tower. The signal.
Please just end
out
the mission. Don't make me have to leave. Oh, thank goodness CR survived. But God, also that clearly wasn't the final mission. There must be a second part to it. I hated that mission. There was no reason for you to only have three troops there. No reason at all. Just to make it artificially more difficult.
Firebrand has cleared the perimeter, sir, meeting limited resistance.
Well done, Doctor.
Yes, it would appear the feedback pulse is having the intended effect.
Shen, status. Did it work?
Advent assures us this breakthrough will be available to all citizens immediately. We go live to the speaker for more.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years we have put our trust in Advent, in the elders, because we believed a better future is possible for all. Today, that trust, that belief, has been rewarded. Advent peacekeeping forces are traveling across the world, carrying the greatest gift from the Elder. A revolutionary gene therapy, yes, but so much more. This is an end to disease, to decay, to pain. The beginnings of a new tomorrow, available to all of us today. Truly. Humanity finally takes its rightful place amongst the stars.
Oh, Taya's gonna be wounded for sure. If I didn't have soul food on that mission, I wouldn't have done that. Command. No way in hell. You have to bring a side trooper to that mission. Deployment. Gravely wounded. So, I guess we go back to the world map now and something else happens. If all the final steps of the game are like that, then I'm very disappointed in the finale. Because that was just artificially difficult. Still, we did it. Next time we'll be doing the next final mission, I guess. Come back for that. Ta-da for now.